Hi folks, Larry, Mobile Tech, here from CanhamTrailers.com, and I've got a little quick tip for you today. I'm about ready to apply Formica to the countertop for the 66 Super Shasta. Now this isn't the only Formica I got to do. I've got to do the same thing with the tabletop, but today I'm only interested in the countertop. So I'm just going to show you a quick little tip when you're how to glue Formica to whatever surface that you're gluing it to. There's a little trick that we use to make things a little easier because we're going to be using contact cement. Now if you've never used contact cement before, you're going to want to read all the instructions, precautions, and all that good stuff, which is a whole lot of small fine print. But the two main things that you need to know is that the way contact cement works, and the reason they named it this, is that it's applied to both surfaces. And what you do is you apply it to the back of your Formica, and you also apply it to the back of the, or the top of the countertop. This is the countertop for the 66 Shasta that I made, and that's where we're going to apply it. This Formica to. Anyway, a little tongue twisted this morning. It's kind of early, and it's a Monday morning. So this is some really neat Formica that the owner bought. It's got that retro look. I don't know what it's called, that particular design. I'm peculiar to boomerang design, but this is another retro look. So what we're going to do is we're going to use a foam roller, 6-inch roller, and we're going to apply our contact cement to the back of this surface, the Formica, and we're also going to apply contact cement to the top of the countertop. And then we're going to wait for about 20 minutes and let that all dry till it's tacky. You should be able to touch the stuff without it sticking to you. And then I'll show you the little trick that we're going to use that involves these quarter-inch dowels. You can use any kind of sticks of wood as long as they are clean and don't have debris falling off of them and things like that. But these dowels were really cheap, and so they're just really easy for me to use. So you're going to need about 4 of these dowels for this size project. You're going to need the 6-inch roller. You're going to need some weld wood contact cement, and you're going to need a rolling pin. Yeah, a rolling pin. And you're going to need these dowels. I think I already said that. So let's move on with the project. All right, so the first thing we're going to want to do is open our material, our contact cement. Oh boy, you can really smell that stuff. And what they tell you to do in the instructions is to mix this with a paint stick. So let's grab a paint stick and mix it up. All right, so we're just gonna go ahead and gently mix this. I'm noticing already that there's some thick stuff in the bottom that we need to mix up. I can feel it. So when you pick this up at the store, you may want to take it to the paint department and have them shake it for 5 or 10 minutes. Try not to make a big mess. I put some paper down here because I don't really want to get this all over my nice table that I built. All right, we're ready to apply it. Some goopy stuff. So all I'm going to do is dump some on there right in the middle. Don't go crazy with it, as a little bit goes a long way. And then we'll start spreading it around and rolling it. You don't want it any thicker than need be. But you want full coverage. Now the Formica, when I cut it, I made it about a half inch bigger all the way around than what I need. And that's so that we can take a router to it and route the edges off nice and clean with the countertop, the wooden countertop later. This is just to show you how to put the Formica onto the surface that you're gluing it to easily. You can see the entire process in my DeVille series. It's all in there. Make sure it's evenly covered everywhere. You've got a 2-hour working time here, so no need to hurry. And we're going to need just a little more. Just a little. There. I'll go over there. So it's pretty close. Stuff is really gets to you. You need a nice open ventilated area for this. There, get it all nice and smooth and rolled out. Make sure you're completely covered everywhere. And then let it sit. Now we'll do the same thing to the wooden top here. Go ahead and dump a little bit here, not quite as much because we don't have as big of a surface because of that sinkhole in the middle. Move it around first. Get it everywhere. You don't want it globbing over the sides either, over the edges. So make sure you're completely covered here, especially in these small areas, like right here. You want to feel it tacky. Make it nice and smooth. And now we'll let it sit for about 10-15 minutes. If you're dealing with a porous surface like plywood, you might want to put a second coat on there. And it will just allow it will mix with the first coat and kind of reliquify it. So that's what I'm going to do. And I just cleaned up the can, don't want to get it all messy again, so I'm just going to dip the roller in there. It's a little easier to do it like that rather than pouring. There, get it on like that. There. And do a second coat, just because this is very, plywood is porous. And you want to make sure you make a good contact the first time, because there's no second chance on this. If it doesn't make good contact, you're stuck, and you've wasted your plywood countertop, which you'll have to rebuild, and you've wasted the Formica, because you won't get it off. No way you'll get it off. So we're doing this just as a precaution to make sure that we got plenty of sticky on there. So look for the glistening glean to make sure that you got it everywhere. And you can also feel it too when you're moving the roller. It's kind of tacky. there's our second coat, all nice and smooth. We'll let that dry now. All right, we've let it dry for about 20 minutes. It's a nice warm day. Not too warm, not too humid. So that should do it. And here's where the big trick is. This is the big secret for applying any two surfaces together using contact cement is these dowels. These are quarter inch dowels, but you can use any kind of sticks. And what you want to do is place these on top of your work, one near each edge, okay, and then evenly space them throughout the project like that. Now they're not going to stick because the surface is dry now. And then we're going to take our pre-cut material, our formica in this case, all right, and we are going to place that on top. And those dowels are going to hold the surfaces apart until we get them where we want them. See? So I cut this formica to be about a half inch larger all the way around. So we just want to make sure it's evenly spaced over our project all the way around. Because we're going to take a router afterwards and route the edges. And it's evenly spaced, so we're going to start in the middle and remove a dowel, just like that. And we're going to press down on this to get it started. And remove this one, move in the outward direction from the center. And we'll take this one out, move outward from the center because you don't want to have any bubbles. And then finally the last one, move outward from the center, press down on it, okay? Now, for the final touch, to make sure that we have good contact, we're going to take our rolling pin. Remember the rolling pin? We're going to start in the middle, apply pressure. About 25 pounds per square inch is what they recommend. And I don't know what that equates to. Be careful not to break the edges. You want it good and stuck on the edges, but you don't want to break it over the side. So you want to be careful. Now you can buy commercial rollers, like they're not quite this big, they're one-handed, and actually you'll see one in use if you go to the flooring video for the 66 Super Shasta. That guy had one, and I want one of those. I tried to find one yesterday, and they just didn't have them anywhere here, so next time I go to a big town like Reno or Carson City, probably when I go to my next Harbor Freight visit, which is in Carson, I'll be able to find one there. Because, see, that's what I didn't want to do, but it didn't hurt it. You got to be careful. You don't want to break that over the edge. But I broke it, but it didn't go too far, so I'm okay. You know, I make mistakes so you don't have to, remember? Seems like these things only happen when I'm videoing. So. Yeah, I'm thinking the commercial one is sort of hard rubber too instead of wood. So it's actually going to work even better. So we've got that down there now. Now all we have to do is route it out. All right, here we go. I'm going to use my safety glasses And I've got the router set up with a 1/4 inch bit. It's got the little bearing here on the side, so this is a side cutter bit. And the bearing allows it to roll along the edges up against the plywood. I'm going to go ahead and clamp this piece down so it doesn't move. Of course, I'll have to move the clamps to get around where they are. Just don't want it moving, so lightly clamp it. We'll route everything we can, and then we'll move the clamps. So here we go. Remember that the router bit turns in one direction, and you want to go against that turn. So in this case, we're going to be going counterclockwise to go against the cut. I think I've shown you that in other videos where I'm using the router. So here we go. Now let me just move the camera a bit so you can see what's going on here. My clamp's in the way. See how easy that is. Now I'm just going to move my clamps so I can get the rest of this. There we go. Now we need to route out the sink hole. So we're just going to drill a hole in the middle where the sink is and then route out from there. All right, so I know that my sink hole is right there. I can feel it. I'm going to go near the edge. That's all we do, right there. Now this is an inside route. We went counterclockwise to do the outside cut. Now we're going to go clockwise to do the inside cut. There is our sink hole. Here's the trim for the sink hole. The sink clamps to the bottom of this trim when we go to put it in. That fits nice and tight. There. It's a little bit of a tight fit, but it works. There it is. So there is our sink. Now what we're going to do to make this waterproof is we'll put putty tape under here before we actually install it, and that way any water getting under here won't drip down into the cabinet. So that's it. There's your tip on installing Formica. All right, so thanks for watching today. I want to take a little time to thank all my new patrons. We've got a bunch of new ones that signed up over the weekend. We're gearing up and getting ready for class. I'm waiting for the new computer, which is going to go right back there. When that gets here, I've got to go ahead and configure it, but I've already got the wire run into the shop for the Ethernet cable, and we've already done most of our testing. I will be putting out an announcement for my patrons on how to actually sign up for the class. One of the things that you're all going to need in order to be able to join in on the classes is you're going to need a Google Plus account. That's the only way that I can make the class private so that only the patrons who are signed up can get into the classroom. So you're going to need a Google Plus account. You're going to need to be a patron with a minimum pledge of $5 a month. And once you have all that done, you're going to be welcome into the classes. Which, like I say, will only be for patrons. So it's the only way I can control the people coming in. Otherwise, anybody could get into it. So because of trolls, we have to be able to control, I gotta be able to control who comes into these classrooms. But so far, I'm happy, and I can't wait to get the classes going. We're gonna have to run a couple more tests. And again, I want to remind you, go get a Google Plus account if you don't already have one. If you don't have a Google Plus account, you won't be able to get into the classroom. The first class will be an orientation class, and hopefully I'm going to get that started by next week. Depends on when the computer gets here. I've got to get it set up and run some more tests. But hopefully we'll have our first class next week. I'm also going to put out a poll for times when the best time to cover everybody would be. And this is gonna be another pretty tough little cookie to crack. I'm gonna put out a poll and ask all my patrons for the best time that I could be broadcasting. Doesn't mean that you'll get that time, but I'm gonna try and put it all together so that we're on live when the most people can tune in. So with that, I hope that I helped you somewhat with this little trick here on Formica and using contact cement. I'm going to do the same thing to the dinette table, but I won't have to put that on video because it's basically the same as what you just saw. So with that, this is Mobile Tech, Larry from CanhamTrailers.com. Be safe out there when you're towing, and we'll see you later. Have a good one.